right now, I want to introduce a young man who's going to come before you and make some notes about some comments about one of the things that we do here at TAP. Mr. Sealey.
Joe, Aaron, I mean, you guys do a bit. I can't believe the progress, the evolution of this organization and how far it's come just a few short years. You guys are incredible people, and just keep doing what you do. I just want to say a few words about my father. I thought a lot about it when I was driving down to St. Louis last night. And really, I want to kind of summarize him in three short descriptive words: humility, integrity, and pride. Everyone who knows my father knows that that really encapsulates him: humility, integrity, and pride. He's very humble the entire night. He would tell me, "Dee, I don't even know why I'm with you. Why did they choose me to be honored this evening?" And that's the type of man he has always been his entire life, through his various accomplishments. He doesn't reflect upon when he sits on his laurels. He's always reaching back into the community and trying to help others to reach higher heights as well. In terms of integrity, I don't know a person who's more upright or moral than my father. And that's the guy's honest truth. Doesn't smoke, doesn't really drink, what did you say, Jake? Sweet tea or water? None of that. Doesn't cheat at anything. I think he would feel completely out of place on our trips to Myrtle Beach. he's just one of the most honest and upright people I've ever met in my entire life. And in terms of pride, I want to just spend a moment on this, because this is what he is at his core. My father is the proudest man I know. His pride just overflows on everything that he is about. He's proud of his country, and he's beautifully served, even with its flaws, and he doesn't dwell upon them. He actually rolls up his sleeves, and he affects change. That's what a man of action, and not just a man of words. I'm very proud of him about that. He's proud of his community, and you, the people here in this room, and also it means his church, his neighbors and other things. It means the people who actually get out and help the less privileged and the less fortunate among us. That means the Atlanta Pinseekers. So that is something that I'm very proud of about him as well, and what he's all about. And finally, I kind of mentioned it in passing, but he is extremely proud of his family. First and foremost, he's proud of the love of his life, my mother, Sylvia Mays, to whom we've been married for 37 years. He's also very proud of his grandchildren, the oldest of whom is with us this evening, my beautiful daughter, Jillian. He's very proud of his sisters and his nieces and nephews and his in-laws, and he's also very proud of our extended family, the Clearys, David, Stephanie, Darius, whom we love very dearly. So I can go on and regale you with all kinds of accomplishments from my dad's military leadership, his student leadership, his community leadership, his civil rights leadership, his business leadership. But suffice to say, his humility, his integrity, his pride is who he is. And that's what makes him a giant of a man, a role model, an inspiration to us all, and mostly and selfishly for me, my best friend in the world. We love you, Dad. Congratulations.
Thank you.
award from the Pinseekers Men's Golf Association. Sorry. But I'm very, very proud to get this. And as Derrick said, I am wondering how I'm living up to this. This is an amazing thing. And I've always come up to like when you receive some of the awards, particularly from an outstanding organization like this organization is. Two things occurred to me when I first started thinking about this, in kind of a joking way. Two things happen as you start getting a little older like I am now. First of all, people want to come to you and start saying to you, you know, you're starting to look pretty good. That tells me, hey, I'm getting older, and they feel comfortable enough to be able to tell me that I'm getting pretty good now, you know? The second thing that happens very often, and I'm really proud of this, is that they start to reward you with some of your accomplishments. You know, you're getting a little older, when people want to start saying, hey, you never give you a pat on the back. And that makes me feel really good. I just want to thank you guys. I want to thank Tim, and I want to talk with my good friend Joe Baldwin, and of course Leon Sealey. These are the guys that originally came to me and said we want to form this organization and can you help us do it? And we sat down and we incorporated them and we got it done, and I'm really proud of the result of that. So I want to have my wife stand up. Sylvia, can you just stand up? Because without Sylvia, I know I wouldn't have been able to do the things that I've been able to do. That's my backbone. She's been with me my entire adult life, and you know, I love what you do. I love you. I love my family, and I'm very proud of what you've been able to do here. So, I'm not going to spend a lot of time. Just thank you so much, all of you who are here tonight, and again to the Men's Association. Thank you so much for taking a deal with me to give me this award. Thank you so much. Go ahead,